to send a little extra special card to let someone know how amazing they are, why not try the fancy window card? This is one of my favorite cards here lately. And guys, I can't wait to show you how easy they are and what minimal supplies they take. They carry a big wow factor. I think you're going to enjoy creating these. So I've got three cards to share with you. Let's get started creating. Guys, I know you are just going to absolutely love the fancy window card. Let me kind of show you how this card works. So basically what we have is a belly band for a card. So it creates a really nice window and you still have your great focal image here. Of course, plenty of room to write a message. This is when you just really want to step up a card and send something really special. We're going to talk about all three cards today because they all offer something a little bit different. So we are actually going to create this Love You So Very Much card. You can see with this one, I use designer series paper as my belly band. So let's go ahead and talk about what you need to create this card. And guys, that's it. That is all you need. Isn't that wonderful? We love it when it's minimal supplies. Let's talk about what we need. We're going to start here with the designer series paper. I've chosen some designer series paper from the True Love collection. I love this one because it's all black and white, and I think black and white is so striking. And let me give you the measurements, but I have a little trick for you. The length is always going to be the same, 8.5 inches. End of story, 8.5 inches. And then you're going to score it at 4 1/8 and 8 1/4. Now this measurement here, that's the one that is going to be optional for you, depending on what you're doing, what window you're going to use in your card. So let me kind of show you. This one, it's 4 inches. This one is 4 1/4 inches because I wanted a little more space there. Yet this one is only 3 3/4. So really, it's all dependent on that window. So you see, I had a great big window here, so I wanted a little more room. And this one, I just, as long as my love you fit, I knew I was good. Yet this one had a really small sentiment, so I could go even a little bit smaller. That part is going to be totally optional. I'm going to tell you, I would probably go ahead and just start with 4 1/4. And that way you're ready to go. And if you need to trim it down, you can always trim it down. But that's going to keep us from trying to go too small too soon. So I'm going to go 4 inches by 8.5 inches. And remember, my score lines were at 4 1/8 and 8 1/4. Now, we're going to go ahead and work with this piece. And I want to do a little quick snip snip. So here is that little tiny flap. And that, of course, is what's going to seal this up. I'm just going to miter. I just want to take a little tiny snip snip right here, just so that you can see. We just want that to close really nice. I'm going to go ahead and give this one a fold as well. But before I go any further, I want to bring in the other two cards because this one is designer series paper, so it's ready to go. But these, you notice I use cardstock. So if you want to stamp, like here, I just stamped in the corners. This one, you can see I stamped all over the belly band. And you want to go ahead and do that now before we do any cutting, before we do anything, any folding. Let's go ahead and get that stamped. Again, I'm going to use designer series paper, so I know I'm good. We want to give these score lines a really good crease. And now it's time to cut. Now there's my flap, and I'm going to keep my flap off to the right-hand side because I want to focus my window here on the left side. We are going to use layering dies. I'm going to use the layering squares, but again, I want to bring in this one. You see, I use the layering circles. You can also use your layering ovals. If you have another great label type image, it's going to work here, guys. Anything is going to work. I just really love my square labels. So the first thing I want to do is I'm going to bring in my stamp. So I'm going to use the Love You, and that's from the Forever and Always stamp set. And so what I need to do is I need to see what die is going to fit there. So I can just kind of, I'm going to start with my largest one. Little too big, right? So let's move that one. Let's try to go down a notch. Oh yeah, that looks just right. I can see that my love you will fit in there, so we're going to go with this die. And guys, it's that easy. That's how you're going to decide what size die to use. So now it's time to do some die cutting. I'm going to run this through my Stampin' Cut and Emboss machine, and let me go ahead and give you the sandwich for that. You're going to use base plate 1, thin die adapter 2, cutting plate 3, and that's when we can come and bring our designer series paper, our stamped card stock, whatever you're using. You're going to center up your die. Remember that flap, that little thin flap is over to the right. We're cutting on the left. Get that all centered up. Lay your top cutting plate on. Run that through your Stampin' Cut and Emboss machine. And there we go. Boom, we have our window. That is very easy to do. Now, to put this together, we're going to put some adhesive here on this flap. I prefer to use my multi-purpose glue, so we're just going to put some glue right there on that edge, fold it over, seal it up. Now, you could use tear and tape, but just be aware that is a little bit, that's only a quarter of an inch, and it's a little bit tight, so I really prefer the multi-purpose glue. And through the magic of television, I already have that done and ready. Now, I was telling you about the measurements earlier. Now let me tell you the measurements for the card itself. It is 4 inches by 11 inches and scored at 5.5 inches. You know, normally our cards would be 4.25 inch. This is only 4 inches by 11 by 5.5. So that you can see is going to slide right into my fancy window. Okay, now we have some options on where we're going to place that window. So let me bring my originals back in here. And like this card here, I put it right in the center. I wanted it centered in my card. But this one that we're about to make, I wanted to stamp something on the bottom. So I wanted to slide that up a little bit. So it's a little bit taller at the top. This one here, this is with the Tranquil Thoughts stamp set and the matching dies. I wanted more of that detail to show. So again, I slid my belly band up a little bit. I wanted it up a little higher. So this is the point in your card you want to decide where do you want that belly band to go. So remember with this one, we wanted to come up a little bit. So I'm going to leave a smaller area at the top so I have room to stamp here at the bottom. Now, I'm also going to do a little stamping here on a piece of scrap because I wanted to stamp a flower, and we're going to be creating a very bright magenta madness flower right there. So again, through the magic of television, I have stamped that flower in smoky slate. And just a reminder, that is also in the stamp set. So I didn't bring in a new stamp set. So now we are going to come in with our Stampin' Blends, and we're going to color this flower in, and then we're going to die cut it. Now, I wanted to kind of keep my video moving along, so I have already done that for you. It's die cut. It's ready to go. But now we're going to stamp our Love You So Very Much. So I'm going to bring in the Love You. And this one says you so very much, because we could say love you so very much, but you know what? We're going to do something a little different today. It's always fun to learn a new technique, right? All right, we're going to bring in that Magenta Madness ink pad. And so to start, we're going to say love you. We're going to put it here at an angle. By the way, this stamp set also has a set of dies. So if you wanted to, you could die cut it and make it really just pop. But I wanted to keep it simple for you today. So we're going to say love you. And I'm going to take my you and stamp right there. Love you. And now I want to say so very much. So this one already has a you and I don't want that. So guys, I am simply going to put my stamp here on the edge of my ink pad so that I'm only inking up so very much. Now, if that makes you a little bit nervous, you can put a post-it note or a piece of scotch tape right across that U and then remove it before you go to stamp. So very much. That's all I want. We are going to stamp that right down here at the bottom of our card. And here we go. It's time to put the card together. Yes, it is that easy. So to add our flower, We're going to adhere that to that designer series paper. I decided I wanted to use stamp and dimensionals. Now, a little tricky because I sure don't want a dimensional to go here because I want my card to be able to open. That would just be really sad if they got a card and went, yeah, you'll never know what's inside. So let's adhere this with some stamp and dimensionals. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to kind of lay it right here because, see, we've got that U. I don't want to cover up my words. So let's kind of figure out exactly where we want that to go. And then I can add my dimensionals. Yep, that works. This one should be able to go right about there. We are good. Add that flower. And yep, not a problem. I'm sliding and moving just fine. We're going to add one more thing. And I just thought it needed a little ribbon. So I just, with the magenta madness, I just created a really pretty little ribbon. I will adhere that with a mini glue dot. Press your bow right there onto the knot of your bow. And guys, there we go. I mean, I'm telling you, not only is it a really wow card, it's that fast. It's wonderful. Remember, you can use your punches here. You can use your dies here. You could leave it alone if you wanted to and just make the inside the focal. Hey, let's go ahead and bring in these other cards for just 1 minute because I want to talk about what I did here. So actually, we'll talk about this card first because this one, you see, I kind of added dies everywhere there, and I stamped all over the belly band. Then I added my dies and my bow to this card. Now you notice the circle, and then I added a second layer to the inside. Same dies. This is the layering circle dies. I stamped You Are Amazing, and I added some more of the In Bloom. This is from the In Bloom bundle. But I thought that little pop of white really made for a fun card. So you can do layers inside, and remember, you've got your dies out anyway. Now we'll talk about this card, Wishing You a Beautiful Day. This is with the Tranquil Thoughts. And I loved this card because look what happens when you slide it out. That die is from the Tranquil Thoughts bundle. And I don't know if you can see it. There's all kinds of fabulous detail on that. And I just thought, again, it made for a real wow card. On my band, I stamped the trio of flowers in three different colors, Mango Melody, Coastal Cabana, and Gorgeous Grape. My outside here is in Melon Mambo. And then I just stamped the flowers there on the corner. I left the back of it plain. I just wanted to add that little bit to the corners. And by the way, that sentiment is also from this stamp set. So one stamp set, and I was able to create that fabulous card. And then of course, we gotta love our forever and always little quick with our designer series paper. Hey, you know what? I didn't mention it and I should have. Do you know you could also use your embossing folders and you could emboss. I would recommend you only emboss the top just because we don't want things to get too tight. I'd probably leave the back alone. And you would just line up your embossing folder with that score line. Very, very simple. All right, I'm telling you, are you excited? I hope you are. These cards are going to be super simple for you to make. And it's going to be a real wow. You know, the people you send these to are going to be so impressed. So I hope that you guys will give these cards a try. Now, if you need to order any of the supplies I used on my cards today, you can find all the supplies right there at simplysimplestamping.com, or you can look down in the YouTube description for a direct link. Hey guys, if you enjoyed the card today, would you give me a thumbs up on YouTube? And if you haven't subscribed, click that great big red subscribe button, and we'd love to have you as a subscriber here. Thank you so much for being with me today. I appreciate it. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye.